Welcome back, our dear viewers. Now it's time for our daily press review for today, and we are very much delighted to have our dear guest in the studio, Ambassador Ibrahim Shoui, former assistant to the foreign minister. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
And we'll start our press review for today with this piece of news. A fire broke out in a hotel in the area of Erwaii in downtown Cairo late on Sunday. The fire started in a hotel in the area and then reached a number of nearby buildings. 32 fire engines were dispatched to the site of fire. According to the Interior Ministry, 14 people were injured so far. Security officials said that more than 80% of the fire was now under control. And moving on to Al-Ahram, from where we read, a huge military funeral for the martyrs of police. Search commenced for four terrorists who killed the 8 policemen in Helwan, and the Minister of Interior says terrorist attacks will not make us change our stances in protecting the homeland and its people. Terrorism hits Helwan, the Brotherhood said, raising the flag of Daesh assistance. A police officer and 7 policemen with 120 bullets from an automatic weapon. And still with the same issue from El Masri Elyoum, 8 new martyrs in the war on terrorism. Investigations show that 4 armed terrorists targeted the police vehicle in Helwan, and the Interior Ministry says we shall continue with our sacrifices. The funeral turned into rallies calling for revenge and terrorism assistant 8 policemen. The martyr police officer is the son of general in the national security apparatus, and the investigation showed that the operation was prepared some time earlier. And we are still with the same issue, but this time from Elyoum Seba. The blood of the police martyrs watered the soil of the homeland in Helwan. 4 terrorists shot 120 bullets from automatic weapons on a young police officer, and 7 policemen were riding a police vehicle. And the attack lasted for 5 minutes. And the military funeral was held on Sunday at the police academy for the 8 policemen who were killed in the terrorist attack. And an unidentified gunman opened fire on the 8 policemen in Cairo's southern district of Helwan. The Ministry of Interior said in a statement that 4 gunmen with automatic weapons got out of a small pickup truck, stopped the police vehicle, and sprayed it with bullets, and then fled the scene. To shed more light on this issue, we have the following report by Ines Hakes.
Military funeral was held on Sunday for 8 policemen who were shot dead on Cairo's southern outskirts in a terrorist attack. The Interior Ministry said that 4 assailants in a truck intercepted a van carrying the policemen in the district of Helwan, just south of Cairo, and sprayed them with automatic rifle fire. It added that those killed in the shooting included a lieutenant and 7 policemen who had been on patrol in plain clothing. Interior Minister Magdi Abdel Ghaffar told state television that the police hold their heads high and won't bow them to any attempt to defeat their will. Militants have killed hundreds of policemen and soldiers in attacks, mostly in the Sinai Peninsula and also in and around Cairo, since Mohamed Morsi was deposed in July 2013. Militants had carried out a previous attack in Helwan, killing a policeman standing guard outside the museum in June 2015. In March, gunmen killed 15 policemen at a checkpoint near Al-Arish, the provincial capital of North Sinai. For its part, the military says that it has killed more than 1,000 militants.
Welcome back, sir. Yesterday we have seen this terrorist attack on a group of police officers, yes, and conscripts in Helwan. More blood from the marchers of the Egyptian police. How do you see this development, and the fight that the Egyptian police officers and army officers are still exerting in order to protect our soil?
Really, this is very unfortunate, and but it is continuing from these terrorist groups to try to make an instability in the Egyptian society. They don't care. Those people, they don't belong to the Egyptian soil. They don't care about their families even. Mm. They don't care about anything. Their breeding and their education was wrong. Why? Because to attack the policemen in that way and 120 bullets, that means those people, they don't have any kind of care about the life of people.
Yeah.
They don't have any care about the security of the people. They care only. And I am very sure that those people will be captured, and we will see that they were paid to do this kind of thing.
Indeed, indeed. And hopefully that they got caught, sir, and brought to justice in order to revenge our martyrs.
As others had happened.
Indeed.
This is not the first time. Indeed. It is continuing. But this is the last breath for those groups.
In
you know,
to stabilize the country.
They are continuing and have very, very, what can I say? This is something doesn't have any kind of belonging to
indeed
anything except blood and except money.
Mm.
Money and money and money. They are playing this game for money.
Indeed, sir. And back to Al Ahram, from where we read, the Press family tackles means of solving the crisis in response to an initiative by Al Ahram, holding an extraordinary general meeting to withdraw confidence from the Council of the Syndicate and refusing the stance of Press Supreme Council regarding the crisis, all the generations and the current in the meeting of the Press family in Al Ahram. And Muhammad Abdel Hadi, confrontation or inciting killing. We are aiming at preserving the dignity of journalists and the syndicate, highly respect of the head of state. And Makram Muhammad Ahmed says, we thank Al Ahram for the new wake-up call. And Salah Muntasir says, the crisis emerged from the presence of a mistake that was wrongly dealt with. And still with the same issue from Al Masri Lyon. An attack on the journalist syndicate from the reforming of the courts front of the House of Representatives. And Kalesh says, we are not going to enter into a struggle. And five members from the syndicate council attend the Ahram meeting. Still with the same issue from Al-Yom Saba, the Al-Ahram meeting calls for an emergency general gathering to withdraw confidence from the council of the syndicate and reveals the council of the syndicate deceived the journalist with false information. A member of the syndicate council, Hatem Zakaria, reveals the details of a phone call between a police officer and the national security and Alesh. And the Speaker of Parliament says the Ministry of Interior executed the law in entering the syndicate. Sir, still with the same issue of the press syndicate and how they are dealing with that problem that occurred between different members of the syndicate and other journalists and, of course, many parties. So how do you see the development of the syndicate?
I think all the intellectuals in Egypt now must come to one track of understanding that keeping the institutions of the state is very important.
Indeed.
You know, syndicate of journalists, syndicate of doctors, syndicate of pharmacology and these people, and all these syndicates, they are institutions.
Indeed.
So the why to you would like to go on and confrontation. Mm. I think usually if even there were a mistake from the Ministry of Interior, it doesn't mean that you don't like to meet the Prime Minister.
Mm. Indeed.
They asked that Minister of Interior must resign.
Mm.
No, you cannot put preconditions to solve any problem. And this is the state. There is something called state. So I think this is not the way. Usually the intellectuals, all those intellectuals, lawyers, doctors, journalists, whatever, they have to understand that we are now in a very dangerous state.
Indeed.
That are suffering. And the Egyptian state nowadays, it is passing from a very crucial state.
Indeed. And from اليوم السابع, we read expectations regarding the return of the Italian ambassador to Egypt soon. An Italian newspaper expects the return of the Italian envoy to Cairo and intensive meetings with the Italian investigators in Cairo to reveal the secrets of hacking the private laptop of Regani. Still with the issue of Regani and the developments that followed his killing, some news about expectation regarding the return of the Italian ambassador to Egypt. How do you see the developments concerning
that issue? I think the ambassador will be back because, you know, the responsible of the Italian parliament was here in Cairo, and he said that the Egyptian government is not responsible about anything about Regani. And he declared that here in Egypt when he visited 10 days ago.
Yes.
No responsibility for Egypt, that means the security authorities cannot be indulged in such kind of crime. It's a very big crime. How come that security would be responsible for this kind of crimes? So this is game played by intelligence in the area who wants to make problems for Egypt with Italy, Egypt with Russia, Egypt with the United States. You know, all these kind of intelligence playing games here is also against Egyptian state.
Indeed.
We have to look and be very alert for all these kind of things.
And we read now from Al-Ahram, tackling the Syrian crisis in Vienna. The Turkish army infiltrates the Syrian depths, and Vienna hosts an extended ministerial summit to tackle both the Syrian and Libyan crises. And the Syrian warplanes attack militants near the northern city of Aleppo as the government tried to push back an insurgent advance in the area. And the Turkish shelling kills 55 Daesh insurgents in the northern of Syria. And Turkish artillery fire hits the region of Suran and Tal el-Hisn, north of Aleppo, as well as Baragdash and Kushak, taking out 3 rocket installation and 3 vehicles, in addition to the killing of the militants. Still with the development, sir, in the Syrian territories and the tackling of the issue in Vienna, how do you see the development on the ground?
You know, the Syrian issue is, to my mind, is a fighting between all the powers in the region.
Yes,
Iran, Russia, United States, Turkey, and all West and East. They are playing on the Syrian ground. But it's very simple to tackle with this matter. There must be now ceasefire and coming to the table, talking together, and have a period of peace and truce for some time, that everyone come to, and there must be all the foreign forces which are in Syria now must be out, except the forces that was asked to come by the government. But others must not be there. Daesh and all these people are mercenaries. They are terrorists. They are working not only against to topple President Assad. No, they want to topple the Syrian state. And this is very important. The Syrians must understand that this game is played against their country. And there must be the Mistura efforts must go on in this way to stop interference from those terrorists and these mercenaries.
Indeed. And the last item we have chosen for today comes from Al-Ahram. Scandals chase Erdogan children. Question marks regarding the sources of the revenues of the family of the Turkish president. Reports say that Erdogan received 50,000 euros annually, and the fortunes of his children exceed millions. The German Bild newspaper reveals in its report on Sunday the size of corruption that is spreading among the family of the Turkish president, Recep Tayyip Erdogan. Some news about how German newspaper revealed some corruption charges or some corruption news about the fortune of the Turkish president,
in fact,
Recep Tayyip Erdogan.
It is unfortunate that Erdogan has so many problems. His international policy is not working well. His domestic policies are very, very bad. And the accusation of corruption also, this is very dangerous thing.
Indeed.
And he is now is not in good terms with Ahmed Davud Oglu, who was
resigned. Yes,
and he was very close to him. So Erdogan, in fact, he is now in a very bad shape. I hope that things will be better for the Turkish future.
Hopefully, Ambassador Ibrahim Shoumi, former assistant to the foreign minister, thank you very much,
thank
sir,
you.
For being with
dear.
Us, and have a lovely morning.
Thank you very much.
And with that, our dear viewers, we come to the end of our press review for today. Now we'll go to a short break, and after that, we'll be back to resume the segments of The Breakfast Show.